We need to talk about oceans. Over the past half century, we've all been stuck in a throwaway culture. Gone are the days when you'd own a product for a lifetime, and maybe even pass it on to your kids. With the rise of disposable plastics, the vast majority of what we use gets thrown away. Out of sight, out of mind has been the mentality. Except, that doesn't mean it doesn't exist. All the plastic you've ever chucked out still exists somewhere. And much of it is in the ocean. We're all increasingly aware of the problem and of the colossal gyre of plastics floating in the Pacific Ocean. In fact, more than 1 million seabirds and 100,000 marine animals die annually from plastic pollution. Something has to change. That something is the Ocean Cleanup, a nonprofit environmental engineering organization dedicated to ridding our oceans of plastic pollution. In this video, I'll explore the unimaginable scale of plastic pollution and how it's devastating marine communities worldwide. And I'll investigate the Ocean Cleanup's genius plan to save our oceans. Here's a terrifying stat. There'll be more plastic in the ocean than fish by 2050. It's hard even to comprehend the scale of so much waste or how you could clean it up. For a start, it's critical to know how it got there. Plastic, produced using the oil industry's waste products, took off in the 1950s. Early plastics were heavy and expensive to produce, meaning little was wasted during those early years. Even by 2000, plastic production and consumption were a fraction of today. Let's put it in perspective. Of the 9.2 billion tons of plastic estimated to have been produced between 1950 and 2017, more than half was made since 2004. If trends continue by 2050, global plastic production will top 1.1 billion tons annually, a truly staggering statistic. Given the sheer scale of the industry, processing all of this plastic waste is getting harder and harder. It's estimated 40% ends up in uncontrolled dump sites, some of it also burnt, and a tiny fraction is recycled. If that all sounds a little vague, it's because it is. In truth, no one really knows where all the world's plastic goes. We know that the waste is largely mismanaged, however. That's led to a significant uptick in the volume of plastic flowing into our oceans, especially as global recycling and landfill titans like China and Southeast Asia find themselves overwhelmed by a tidal wave of waste. For example, it's estimated we've already seen a tenfold increase in plastic in the oceans. Nor is it just littering and throwing plastic into landfills causing ocean waste. Plastic microbeads or microfibers from clothing all contribute to the growing microplastic problem. These microscopic particles of plastic are causing havoc through ecosystems, disrupting the normal biological functioning of marine animals. We found microplastics inside humans, a frightening thought. After all, you are what you eat. And if you eat fish containing plastic, you're eating plastic. Much of the plastic in the ocean enters five giant floating plastic patches. The Great Pacific Plastic Patch, for example, is bigger than the size of Texas, and plastic has been found 11 kilometers below the surface. The whole ocean is contaminated. What's the harm? How is all this plastic affecting marine life? It's straightforward. Animals who eat near the surface are ingesting plastic. Because they can't digest plastic, it builds up in their system, filling their stomachs and preventing them from eating real food. In short, they starve to death. In one heartbreaking example, 100% of baby sea turtles have plastic in their stomachs. And sea turtles caught in fisheries see 74% of their diet composed of ocean plastics. After all, if you're not eating fish, you're eating plastic. Elsewhere, coral reefs, already stressed from ocean acidification, are further hampered by marine plastics. The likelihood of coral becoming diseased increases from 4 to 89% after contact with marine plastic. The plastic damages the coral's skin, opening it up to infection. Aside from climate change, ocean plastics are likely the biggest environmental problem on the planet, possibly ever. To call it shocking is an understatement of global proportions. Plastic pollution simply cannot continue. It's time we cleaned up our act. That's where the aptly named Ocean Cleanup comes in. Founded in 2013 by Dutch-born inventor and entrepreneur Boyan Slat, the organization aims to extract plastic pollution from the oceans and intercept it in rivers before reaching the ocean. They've developed several different systems to achieve this goal, including the Interceptor and the Ocean Cleanup System 1 and 2. The Interceptor's concept starts with a fascinating stat. 80% of river plastic comes from just 1,000 rivers. The Interceptor is set to trawl those rivers in the next 5 years, preventing plastic from reaching the ocean. The process works in 5 simple steps. First, a barrier pulled by the Interceptor guides plastic waste in the water towards the conveyor. The plastic is continuously extracted from the water and onto the shuttle. The shuttle automatically distributes the debris equally across 6 dumpsters using sensor data. Inside each dumpster, up to 50 square meters of waste is stored. When full, it automatically sends a text message to local operators who come and collect the waste. The elegant simplicity of the design means it can work 24/7. Relying on solar power to keep the Interceptor's conveyors, sensors, and data transmission systems running. It's also scalable, able to be adapted to virtually any river in the world. Working round the clock in optimal conditions, the Interceptor extracts up to 50,000 kilograms of plastic per day. You can currently see Interceptor working in some of the world's biggest rivers, including Jakarta, Indonesia, the Klang River in Malaysia, and Kingston Harbor, Jamaica. It's only the beginning. The Ocean Cleanup System 1 works in a similar fashion. However, after completing modeling, a 100-meter segment was tested in the brutal North Sea conditions in 2016. The battering it received from the waves meant the design couldn't handle the stress. It was back to the drawing board. System 1 works by detecting hotspots of plastic. These natural, ever-shifting locations require computational modeling to detect. Once located, the system moves into place. It consists of a large suspended net, which is dragged through the water. The slow-moving design does not cause animals to get caught, but still funnels the plastic waste into collection tanks. The system was a passive collection apparatus, meaning it worked in tandem with the ocean's currents, the same currents causing the plastic to accumulate in the first place. The ocean cleanup stresses the importance of such a system now, as 92% of the plastic debris remains large enough to be collected, which will change as the plastic degrades into microscopic pieces. Despite the success of System 1, System 2 is now being launched, nicknamed Jenny. Jenny is substantially quicker than its predecessor, involving an 800-meter long and 3-meter deep barrier towed through the water by 2 boats. It moves at 1.5 knots, or less than 2.5 miles an hour, so fish have plenty of time to escape. Due to the currents generated by the net, the plastic is shuttled towards a central repository called the retention zone. After a week of operating in the water, one of the boats will collect the retention zone, permanently removing the plastic from the water. The plastic is then stored and sent for recycling. It's efficient, effective, and potentially planet-saving in its approach. You can even track its movements on their website. Now, the team is moving ahead with developing System 3, which will be even more audacious than before. It will serve as a blueprint for scale up when the ocean cleanup moves towards industrial-scale plastic removal. It's a remarkable journey in just 8 years. But what do you think? Is this plastic cleanup operation one for the history books? Or have we doomed our ocean for millennia as a plastic soup? Let us know in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to watch other videos on our channel. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.